Remakes, adaptations, and reboots. Well, what even are they? And why do we continue to repurpose old content for the modern audience? In this video essay, I'm going to share the reasoning behind the remaking of media and explore why our consumerist group loves updated takes on older stories. I'll share my thoughts, opinions, and explore if remakes can ever be truly faithful to the source material. Let's jump into it. Making sure you can understand the differences and the definitions between remaking versus adaptations provides a really, really good place to start, as there are profound difficulties in classifying content. The phrases remakes and adaptations are defined as being different, as they do share key differences in both structure and results. Adaptations are based on stories of novella, whereas remakes or reboots attempt to better a previous version of the same topic or source material. This, however, only holds certain power, as many often define remakes as a form of adaptation. With this synonymous-like thinking associated with the naming conventions, it becomes ever more complex when trying to separate these two definitions. For example, the 2006 film Casino Royale is a remake of an unofficial spoof Bond film, but at the same time is also a faithful adaptation to the original Ian Fleming book of the same name. It explores the introduction of Daniel Craig's Bond character and blends the newer on-screen styles with the updated work and also the history of past work and novella. We learn that the conversion and interpretation of a story from page to screen can change the tone of the film, because this cross-comparison between these two shows the stark changes. Craig's Bond is dark and gritty, whereas in the 1967 version, it's more of a satirical nudge at the retro films of the time. When we take up the lens of analysis to our subject topic, we need to look closely at the types of media created, as there are also key differences in the classifications associated with them. We don't have a sense of unification when it comes to remakes, as they provide different perspectives to the original material. Just think of it, a single story can be told in hundreds of different ways, with extended tones and meaning, changing the interpretation of the source material. This is arguably because we're seeing a new version of the story, but surely adaptations also change the original content and tonal properties, meaning that the work could fall into both categories, where both labels are required. In order to show such differences in adapted works, I would refer to the 2005 film Charlie and the Chocolate Factory, as it is both an adaptation from the original Roald Dahl book, but an also extended remake of the 1970s film. The strong, more modern-day technology aids in showing more on screen, but it doesn't feel as natural as the earlier interpretation. They both tell the same story with an almost identical narrative structure, but at the same time, due to the conversion via screenwriters, the story feels completely different. When you alter the story, it changes the definable meaning, thus moving away from a fully faithful remake or adaptation. The phrases are used as a dual meaning, but this doesn't warrant technical accuracy. In order to understand why works aren't fully faithful, we need to explore the way stories are translated in order to work with a new medium. Screenwriters must create content that is inspiring and interesting, something that provides to be harder than ever with growing numbers of non-original stories. But how do you make an adaptation or remake sound interesting while still providing accuracy to the source material? To put it simply, creating fully faithful adaptations or remakes are outright impossible, as changing the medium results in a shift of factual accuracy. Having an audiovisual depiction makes it easier for some viewers to understand the story, but at the same time, you are bound by the choice of showcase. When you read a book, you decide in your mind what the character looks like, how they react, and how the landscape appears. And we get this in film to an extended degree, but in many ways, this is lost as you only have one image or view. The most faithful adaptations would actually be a direct depiction of what was written on the page, but this is simply not an effective approach. Studies suggest that there are only a few completely original stories, with most appearing similar due to finite narrative formats. This means that the structuring of a story is left to a screenwriter. But what do you remove, you hear screenwriters cry? Well, that's completely up to the person adapting the story. They are the person that decides what is needed for the newer format and which parts will simply not work in the tonal shift. In this process of adaptation, the screenwriters remove details and information that is felt to be too poorly supported by this new work, something that moves away from the faithful accuracy. Although most adaptations or remakes are based on novella and books and works, they may also be based on real-life events. This presents difficulties within itself, however, as a fictitious adaptation of a factual event provides glaring inconsistencies. So which perspective do you include, and how do you make the facts seem exciting yet faithful? Adapted work that is said to have been based on or inspired by true events has a growing demand within the fiction but also factual genre. This is because the audience wants to feel something real, something that relates more closely to their real lives. And when a story is converted from the pages to screen, a few things must be changed for the story to work in a new format. When these creators adapt or remake a story, they must decide on the following things. How will the character look? What story segment are we going to work with? Is there scope to change characters? And how do you make the story interesting? This final question is of actually large contention, as it leads to the creators of stories to stray away from the source material, pushing further away from factual accuracy. As Lipkin states, the arenas that frame performance becomes the means that make the past present. This explores why we choose to stray away from faithful adaptations, reinforcing the ideal that a remake or adaptation will never correctly or faithfully portray the source material. We simply aim to use the current arenas in the form of technology to re-embody the work and change the meaning. Deepwater Horizon shares such inconsistencies with its source event, as it showcases, in a fiction-led narrative, what happened in the terrible BP oil rig disaster. The showcase format is based on accounts from people that were there, but retold with actors taking their place. This extends the personal tones of the film, with making us feel ever more connected. However, screenwriters opted to change certain details, straying away from the real event. A great example of this would be when we see Mark Wahlberg's character Mike Williams come into anger and rage conflict with BP officials, something dramatised in the film and yet was proven to be partly fictitious in real life. In direct polarity with this film, sharing a more biographical interpretation would be the Deepwater Horizon documentary. The screenwriters chose to base this showcase on the direct facts and report, not a narrative form. The documentary tries to hit home with accuracy and information, as it is a non-fiction form instead of a fictitious version found in 2016. Both tell the story of the incident, but in differing ways and accuracy concerning the source material. One may regard the documentary to be more technically accurate and refer it to the more faithful adaptation. This may be due to the choice of showcase, as they both fall into different genre categories. This links back to our perceptive responses, as we need to understand that the differences in showcase choice have a direct correlation to the factual accuracy of what is on screen. Narratives that are shaped for the screen stray from faithful accuracy and may never be truly accurate. Our shifts in the way content is created, with the difficulty classifying adaptations, is of huge interest. As I've highlighted, when changing the medium or format of a story or event, we tend to lose the original story's depth. Showcases bind the viewpoint, enforcing a single representation of what we see. In the fiction genre, we use self-created reference, and for biopics, we are presented with only the facts. Remakes enable newer audiences to understand older stories, but with this, we also lose the accuracy due to faithful adaptations. Fully faithful remakes or adaptations are never possible and will never be truly accurate to the source material, and this is due to several reasons. Primarily in the form of adaptation, where writers and creators simply want to retell a story that is more targeted to the medium that they will be creating, but further into the choice of showcase. Films will of course share different levels of reference accuracy, but at the same time, creators do not want fully faithful remakes, as they are creating their own interpretation of a story. With that, I leave this topic open for comment. Can adaptations be faithful, or do writers no longer care?